Carbanions are commonly encountered reactive intermediates under basic conditions. The stability of carbanions is governed primarily by three factors, two of which we've already seen. The differential electronegativity of the hybrid orbitals means that hybrid orbitals with more s character are better at stabilizing negative charge than those with less s character, such as the sp3 hybrid orbital. More s character pulls electrons closer to the nucleus, stabilizing them as a result. This is why, as you can see here, a cetylide anion is more stable than vinyl anion. Delocalization stabilizes negative charges for the same reason it stabilized positive charges. It spreads charge out. Delocalization into electronegative atoms, such as oxygen, is more favorable than delocalization into less electronegative atoms. This is why ketones, for instance, are more acidic than allyl groups. Delocalization into multiple electronegative atoms is more favorable than delocalization into fewer atoms. As a result, the enolate of 1,3-diketone, shown at the bottom of this slide, is the most stable anion on this slide. One of the subtler points concerning delocalization of both cations and anions is the idea of delocalization competition. If two donors, for instance, are competing for the same acceptor, or two acceptors are competing for the same donor, then the effects of delocalization for the two competing groups will be attenuated. Consider the ester enolate, shown here at right, versus the ketone enolate. Both experience delocalization of the lone pair into the pi star of the carbonyl group. However, the ketone's lone pair can more effectively delocalize because the ester's lone pair on carbon is competing for delocalization with the oxygen atom, which is also able to delocalize into the carbonyl's pi star orbital. The carbon lone pair of the ester enolate is thus less delocalized. It's more basic, more reactive, and more unstable than the lone pair of the ketone enolate. Solvation effects provide an interesting way to decide on the stability trend of the alkyl anions. As you can see here, the smaller alkyl anions, such as methyl and ethyl, are more stable than the larger ones. This is attributed to a lack of solvation of the larger anions due to steric hindrance provided by the large number of CH bonds around those molecules. Smaller molecules, such as methyl anion, experience less steric hindrance, and thus partial positive charges may be present in solution can get much closer to the methyl anion than to the much larger tert-butyl anion.